Somebody carved something in it. But it's barely readable.
Well, let's just play some stuff and see what happens. Okay. So you get the first one, and then if you do a different one, it disappears. So maybe, maybe I keep trying it until I get, like, two, and it resets anytime you do anything wrong? Wait a minute, it shows you what to do, doesn't it? Yeah, look. Left. Yeah, these are telling you what to do. This one's just the left one. It's the little feet! It's all connected! Not only does it show you what to do, but remember the phosphos outside where I played the, my flute nose? And every time I played a certain one of its feet kind of, like, went up or whatever? It moved, it was moving that 1 foot. Or whatever you'd call it, a flap, whatever those things are. Yeah. That is an incredible amount of consistency in the game world, actually. That is really cool. So the next one is 3 and 4. Next one's 3. 2 and 3. 1 and 3. And 1.
Wow, look! Your nose music made them glow. Do it again.
Well, I was wondering what's at the bottom.
Look at that!
They are not real.
Conroy must have built them.
Not Conroy. There's only one Asposian who has the skills to do this. My father must be here somewhere.
Don't be scared, Laura.
Huh? What? Oh! He must be here somewhere. I have to find him.
Wait! What am I supposed to do without you?
Take that.
Huh? A piece of paper?
What?
Good luck!
What?
Laura, I think she ran to that tall, dangerous, ancient-looking building that's surrounded by guards. Great.
She gave me a piece of... Oh, it's a note. Okay. Okay, so her father's been building the, bazillions. But why? Who's been doing this and why? That's the obvious question. Oh look, this changed. Yeah, in the cutscene, it says something in German. It's like Achtung something something. Now it says caution, flight path. You didn't translate everything, game developers. Coffee filter, what the heck? Alright, let's read the note.
I can't use that. It says, hey, look over there. Why did Laura give me this note?
Okay, so, wow. It's like a double distraction. Simply giving me the note was a distraction, but then even reading it is even more of a distraction. I wonder if I'm actually going to end up having a use for it, though. Maybe. Who knows?
Conroy really did create his own flag. He's a megalomaniac.
You're only just now noticing that, Robert?
I can't reach it.
Ah, why do I have to be so short?
This wind-up box and the flag have something to do with each other. I just don't know what.
Oh, Robert. Okay, so I need something to wind it up if I want to get it down, which I don't have yet.
There's a coffee filter in it, and it's filled to the brim with coffee powder.
I can make some coffee, but why would I want to?
An empty coffee pot. I remember that Conroy always took his coffee black. No milk, no sugar, and no mercy.
Black and miserable. Miserable and horrible, just like Conroy. Is that actually a real guard? That is a real guard. A very bad one, too.
A mechanic guard. Hopefully he won't see me. Although that'd be unlikely, even if he didn't have a construction plan in front of his face.
Yeah, I don't think you have anything to worry about.
Hello?
Who's there?
What happened to your knee? That is naturally the next question to ask.
What happened to your knee? Are you hurt?
What? Oh, that. It's an old root ball injury. One of the marching guards tackled me in front of the ghoul. My tendons rolled up like a yo-yo.
Oh.
Yep. Ever since, my knee has been tense as a tightly coiled spring.
Really? Tightly coiled spring? Something tells me it's not a coincidence that you're telling me that.
I think it's part of a solution to a puzzle. Hint, hint.
Can you still play root ball with your busted knee?
Sure, but they don't let me anymore. I kick so hard that nobody can catch my passes. The last guy who tried lost his foot.
Oh.
But that's nothing compared to the guy that tried heading it.
What are you building? Looks like a bazillion.
You think so? Thanks. I already thought of a name for it, too. What do you think of Pompiladonis? Too dramatic?
What's with all the other bazillions? That's almost the whole army.
I haven't thought about names for them yet. But Conroy wanted to name them the Battalion of Destruction.
What?
Don't ask me. I think it's a boring name as well. I mean, where's the subtext?
Yeah.
Do all of these bazillions have petrifying eyes?
Sure. Once I find the part of it that goes in there.
We have to stop him.
What did you say?
I said we have to buy something for his birthday.
Already on it. All the guards are throwing an asp in a pot.
You want to buy a group gift for Conroy?
Boss's order.
Who's your boss?
Conroy.
What a nice boss.
There's a strange flag hanging back there. I've never seen one like it before. What does it mean?
It's the new official flag of righteousness. Abbot Conroy designed it himself.
Oh, yeah, I remember. Art is one of Conroy's hobbies. He was always very creative with his methods of torture.
Oh, he tortures people. Why does that not surprise me?
Why a new flag now? Asposia already has a nice one with a smiling phosphos on it.
No clue. He said something about new era, new flag. I didn't pay attention.
Okay, thanks for the information.
Glad I could help.
All right, there's a lot of stuff here. Round construction piece, clear varnish bucket. Ooh, Allen wrench. That could be used for the wind-up box, if I could get to it.
Can I have that?
No. Only mechanic guards are authorized to use it. You don't look like a mechanic guard.
Oh, sorry.
No problem. I keep forgetting what I'm doing here as well.
Wow, he's a really bad guard. Okay, so I'm guessing I can't get any of these pieces until I look like a mechanic guard, right?
Can I have that?
No. I still need it, I think.
Alright, well, I can't do that just yet.
I think this is the engine room. It's really a machine. Conroy has no conscience. How did I not see through him all these years? It either means Conroy is Asposia's most brilliant liar, or that I'm a giant idiot. No, it's because of Conroy.
Or it's both. I think it's both.
I don't have to pet it. Machines don't have feelings.
Some of them do. Why is there a separate hotspot for the exclamation mark?
It says, attention, in big letters. The exclamation mark gives the word a sense of importance.
Yes, it does. Let's remove that importance.
I can't get it off this way, but I want that exclamation mark.
I do. I want it for no other reason than there's a hotspot at it that tells me I can get it at some point. And that's good enough for me. But I have nothing.
I can't do that.
Nope.
I can't use that. The shaft leads to the wind fountain in the ruins.
What is this? Loose guard picture, guard picture, guard picture. Well, this could work to make me look like a mechanic guard. A wrench was his mate. Oh, hold on, will he read it?
A wrench was his mate. A screw was his fellow. He swallowed his pen. Mechanic guard. I can't make out the rest.
I want to know what the rhyme is. Hold on, is it a super obvious rhyme? Wrench was his mate. A screw was his fellow. He swallowed his pen. Mechanic guard. I don't know. Maybe the rhyme there is super obvious, but I can't figure it out.
Strong as a boar, he lived for the fight, but clucked like a hen, standing guard for white ten.
Standing guard for white ten. We will never forget you.
He used to be alive, then he stepped on a crack and broke his spine. Marching guard 5 black 9.
He used to be alive, then he stepped on a crack and broke his spine. Well.
A guard like any other. Looks like the guard next to him and the guard next to him.
Alright, see if we can grab this picture. Okay. We're in business.
Mechanic guard here, buddy. Can I borrow some of your tools, colleague?
I'm not falling for that one. You're one of those outlook guards that never brings anything back. Tell me your mechanic guard identification code.
Oh, no. Do I actually need to figure out what... Can I use any of their codes, or do I have to actually figure out what the code was? I really don't remember.
Okay. Hey, wait a second. The code has 3 parts.
Sure, I was just about to tell you the second part.
Oh, wait, did I actually get that right? I literally guessed. I have no idea what it was. Okay, what did I even do? 2-8? Hold on, let me write that down. 2-8, I guess I got that right. Yellow?
Oh, that's a great color. Totally underrated. What about the third part?
What? Hold on, I gotta write this down just in case. Am I actually getting this right, or is this just, like, always work? Oh, what? 10?
Do you think I'm completely nuts? As if that's a mechanic guard identification code. I know the codes.
Yet be incapable of tying his own shoes.
Once you go Velcro, you never go back.
Okay, let's go back here. Hold on. Four white, 10. Five black, 9. Spine, 5 black, 9. Now hold on, I did 2-8, yellow. So does this even work? Wrench was his mate, a screw was his fellow, he swallowed his pen, Mechanicard, 2-8, yellow. How the fuck did I get that? I literally guessed. Oh my god. Was there something in the back of my mind that somehow remembered and got that right? Because that is an uncanny thing. I thought I guessed. But I seriously got the first parts correct? A wrench was his mate, a screw was his fellow, he swallowed his pen, Mechanic Guard 2-8, yellow. How did I do that? Okay, but what's the next part? 2-8, yellow. I mean, there's no... Why would there be a second code? I mean, a third part. Why would there be a third part? Or did I get that wrong? I'm confused. I mean, the only three parts is a single digit, a color, and then another digit, right? So 2-8 yellow, even though that rhymes. That can't be it. It'd have to be like 2-yellow-8, but that doesn't rhyme. He swallowed his pen. Alright, screws his fellow, mechanic guard. Yeah, it doesn't end in the color. Hen, 10, spine, 9. Fellow? What number would fellow rhyme with? Fellow 1, fellow 2, fellow 3, fellow 4, fellow 5, fellow 6, fellow 7, fellow 8, fellow 9, fellow 10. Wait, does it not rhyme with any? I'm rhyming with the wrong one, aren't I? 10, spine. I'm rhyming with the wrong one, I'm an idiot. I'm good at puzzles, can't you tell? Let's do this the right way. Pen. Pen 1, pen 2, pen 3, pen 4, pen 5, pen 6, pen 7, pen 8, pen 9, pen 10. I guess I should have seen that one because of hen. Okay, it's 10. So, mechanic guard. 2. But then what's the color? I'm so confused. The color could be anything, could it not? Maybe it can be anything? And it just needs to end in 10? The only part that needs to rhyme is the last one, right? Hold on. Looking for patterns here. Hen, 10. Fight, white. Boar, 4. Oh, everyone rhymes. Okay, got it. Mate 1, mate 2, mate 3, mate 4, mate 5, mate 6, mate 7, mate 8, 8. 8 is the first one, got it. Fellow, which is yellow, 8, yellow. And then pen, which is 10. 8, yellow, 10, got it. Boom. I'm a pro at puzzles, can't you tell?
Mechanic guard here, buddy. Can I borrow some of your tools, colleague?
I'm not falling for that one. You're one of those outlook guards that never brings anything back. Tell me your mechanic guard identification code.
8, yellow 10.
Okay. Hey, wait a second. The code has 3 parts.
Sure. I was just about to tell you the second part.
Oh, that's a great color. Totally underrated. What about the third part? Really? That's funny. I thought you were dead. Well then, help yourself. I have no idea what this is good for anyway, but bring it back.
Okay, that was a really good puzzle. I really, really like that puzzle. Not exactly even sure why, but there's just something really fun about it.
Mechanic Guard 8 Yellow 10 here. I'm taking this with me, okay?
What do you have there?
I don't know exactly.
Okay, take it.
Very protective of his tools.
Can I have that?
No. I still need it, I think.
Okay, you can keep that one. What about the clear varnish bucket?
Mechanic Guard 8 Yellow 10. Can I have this bucket of clear varnish?
Fine by me. I have no idea what it's for anyway. But bring it back.
I will. I totally promise. I will maybe bring it back. Alright, let's get this flag. Don't know why, but I'm gonna get it anyway.
Come here, little flag. Your job just became significantly more interesting.
Yes, it did, although I still don't know what I'm going to use it for. Alright, can't take the Allen wrench back, so we can stay there. Can I get the exclamation mark? With what? Nothing, I don't have anything. Can I make some varnish coffee?
That won't work.
Actually, how does this even work? There's a coffee filter up here, but where's the water feed? I guess that's it going to the top, I think? Where's it coming from, though? Oh, that actually works. Oh god, what the hell am I making?
Coffee's ready.
Yeah.
A pot full of black varnish. I know exactly who I would like to offer some to.
The heck am I gonna do with that? I have it, but I have no idea what to use it for. I guess I should probably go to the next scene, right? The passageway? See what the heck's down there?
Conroy ordered hundreds of them to be built. I'm too small. What can I do?
Oh, Robert, you can do a lot. He's already been doing a lot. Alright, see if I can go down the passageway without being seen by the guards.
Laura must have gone this way. I wish I could jump over roofs like her, but I have to use my head.
Parakeet? Is that a guard parakeet?
Oh, how cute. Someone dressed him up like a little general.
Oh, this game was adorable. Wow, is that seriously how they guard this place? What the heck? Interesting. Okay, well, I can't help but notice that they're walking in, like, black footsteps, and I have some black varnish. I don't see what the connection would be, though.
An alarm bell with a useful-looking little hammer. Oh! Oops. Broken. Hopefully nothing catches fire now. I have to find Laura.
Well, I can probably use that hammer to get the exclamation mark, I'm guessing.
The letters are pretty loose, but this little hammer won't be sufficient.
Never mind. I was just kidding. What do you think I am, stupid? No, seriously though, that's actually a good example of what's wrong with the puzzles in this game. Don't get me wrong, the puzzles are not bad. They're quite good in general, and sometimes really good. But, I mean, look at that. I've tried to use logic in this game before, but it doesn't always work out. Like, I used logic to tell me that the nautrine flowers would not work in the basin, because you can't possibly get enough fluid from them to actually fill up the basin, and yet it did. So that's a case of, okay, it makes no sense in the real world to be able to get enough juice from something that small. But this game kind of exaggerates stuff, so things don't quite necessarily... they're not necessarily as strong... like, quantities aren't necessarily realistic or proportional, right? So then I thought, okay, so if logic doesn't matter, then maybe a tiny little hammer can be used to get off something. To knock something off. But no, apparently it's too small. So even though the nectarine flowers, I had way too few of those to get enough juice to possibly fill up the basin, that worked. In this case, the hammer is too small, even though proportions apparently mean nothing in this game, so I don't get it. You can't use logic to solve it. Which is definitely a flaw with the puzzles, but they're not bad, they're good, in general. But it does have some flaws with the puzzles, definitely. That's one case. You basically have to use everything on everything. The game doesn't play fair. And if the game doesn't play fair, if it's not logical, then you end up having to use everything on everything. You just have to. Because you've left the realm of logic and reason.
A birdcage.
It's headquarters!
Okay. Sorry, parakeet. Also, by the way, you're a very bad guard parakeet, although I guess you're not a... yeah, I guess you're not a guard parakeet, are you? The parakeet actually signals the guards when to move.
Oh, a parakeet. Hey there, birdie. Do you want some seed?
Me? That soldier birdie to you. But I'm not going to turn down seed.
Can I get you?
You can stroke my rump.
What's a rump?
I'm the one asking the questions here. Why are you keeping me from working?
Because stuff.
What are you doing here?
My damn duty! If I didn't keep these idiots working, they'd just stand there until... well, they would just stand there.
Isn't your job a little monotonous?
Sometimes it gets a bit lonely here. Hey, boy, you don't by any chance have a little mirror you could spare, do you?
No. What for?
Or a piece of pumice, maybe?
What?
No.
Oh, never mind then. I'll just claim my plumage again tonight.
Okay. You're a parakeet.
What? Super! Does that mean I can fly?
I just meant that this is an unusual job for a parakeet.
Yeah, isn't it? I started out as a field parakeet. Not a nice job. Saw my comrades fall, one after another.
Oh no, in a war?
No, they fell from the branch. Not a nice sight, I can tell you that.
Can you sing a song?
Does a bird chirp in the woods? No, seriously, bring me a trumpet and I'll prove it to you. Ah, our old marching band, Sergeant Birdie's Lonely Hearts Club.
Are you working for Conroy?
Yes, sir. For over 2 years now. I'm proud of it.
Why?
Finally, someone who stands for order. None of this wishy-washy nonsense about no death penalties and protection of personal freedom and all that lovey-dovey peace talk.
Yeah, terrible.
Yes, I know.
So, you like working for Conroy?
Definitely. When the bazillions are done here, there'll finally be some structure.
What's Conroy's plan?
What does it look like? He ain't planning to throw a party.
Yes, he hates parties. Oh, hang on a second. He wants to conquer Asposia.
He only wants the best for his people. Unfortunately, most people don't know what's best for them. But I've already said too much. Hey, by the way, what's with that seed you promised?
Oh, yeah, about the seed. I don't have any, but I do have some black varnish coffee, if you want some. It'll perk you up. It'll perk you up for about 10 seconds right before you crash to death.
So, the guards here are under your command.
Are you talking about the unit of highly trained specialists? Good guys, everybody has a unique talent.
For example?
For example, the mechanics unit, the absolute elite. Some of those daredevils can even tie their own shoes. Or take the marching guards. Boy, can those guys march as long as there's no obstacles in their way. Like a door, for example.
Oh my god. So what would happen if I just ran through here? Would they even notice? They don't even seem to move unless... What was his name again? Sergeant... something? Unless he tells them to move, they don't even move.
Okay, thanks for the, conversation.
Don't get sentimental, boy.
Okay.
It's screwed on tight.
Because of nitwits like you!
What if I did this?
Yes, and then I'll scream, "Here I am, catch me if you can."
Well, that was my plan. But okay, I'll do something else. It's gotta be something to do with this black varnish.
Looks really deep. No, I'm not that desperate. This path leads to the abyss. I don't know what I'm supposed to do with that. Apparently the guard's task is to follow the footprints, and they go in a circle. Sounds like an inspiring...
Yeah, I mean, they're following the footprints, so obviously I need to do something with that in the black varnish. But I'm not exactly sure what. Can I just go out?
Phew, that was close. They almost saw me.
Like, can I go out now? Because none of them are looking. No.
Apparently the...
Alright, can I just, like...
Phew, they all...
Can I just, like, pour this down?
That could be fun. That won't work.
What am I gonna do with this flag? Might need a hint here soon.
That's just a rant.
Yes, it is. I mean, I could do this. Do this again? Would this work again?
I could hold it in front of my face. Look at me. I'm a god. But what kind of idiot would believe that?
Well, the last one believed that, so...
Phew, that was close. They almost saw me.
I have a tiny hammer. Do you want that, Sergeant?
He's tenacious. I can't slay him.
I didn't want to kill him with a tiny hammer. I seriously don't know what to do here. Okay, just a little hint. Just a little one. Get rid of the marching guards. You have to silence them first, okay?
Do you need a flag?
No. It reminds me of my old boydy comrades, resting in peace under their flags.
Oh, no.
Pull yourself together. They woke up eventually, once the sheets were gone. Damn sleep reflex. But that's our nature. Killer and canary.
Okay, yeah, birds will go to sleep, or at least... start to... they'll generally be quiet if you cover them, so... But he doesn't like the flag because it's colored, so let's paint it, black.
No, now is no time to fool around.
Never mind, it didn't work. Okay, but I need something to cover him with. Poster? That's too small.
Is there a reason why you stuck a god's picture to your nose?
10
push-ups.
Okay, I have no idea. I know I need to cover him. That much is obvious. But how?
Do you need a...
No.
No.
A bird.
It's headquarters.
Yeah, I know. Alright, I need to change the flag. Change the flag. Let's go back. See if there's something back here I've missed. Nah, I don't know. Make use of the parakeet's instincts, yep. What can be done to make a caged bird fall asleep? Cover him. Cover the cage with a blanket, yep. Yes, I do, but... The flag would make an excellent blanket, yes, but he won't accept it. What? Use the flag with a parakeet's cage. I already did. I already tried that game, it doesn't work. Wait a minute, oh, wait, seriously? I can't use it on the parakeet directly, I have to use it on below, which counts as the cage?
So, time to go to sleep.
Hey, what's this? What's that sheet for? No, please, we can work this out! Oh.
Okay, that is... Well, the result is nice. And it's cute, but that was a dumb puzzle. Seriously? I totally got it, but why not make it so that the cage and the bird, if you use the flag on either, it's recognized as a solution? Why do that? I mean, naturally, if you want to put it on the cage, my natural inclination is to use it on the cage part, but you actually have to drag it down below to the part where it's tiny. Like, what? No. No, just no.
Ooh, that was close. They almost saw me.
Alright, so I probably need to freeze them in a different position.
Apparently the guards... If the guard sees me, he'll lock me up. And if he imprisons me, Laura will kill me.
If you're imprisoned, I don't know if Laura can kill you. But yeah. Here, take some black varnish.
I can't do that.
Okay.
No, it's better for everyone if I let him sleep.
No, wait! Don't eat the seed! That's waste!
Underneath, General Birdie is taking a nap. It's suiting that it's a flag.
Johnny! No! You damn bastards!
Okay, did I freeze him in the wrong position? Because I can't seem to take it back out, so...
That's just a...
Whoops. I mean, this doesn't work. I already tried this, right?
I could hold it in front of the wall. Phew, they...
Okay.
They almost... I can't steer... Yes, and then I'll scream...
Okay.
Phew, they almost...
I don't get it. I really can't take the flag off, huh?
It's screwed up. A bird... No, it's better...
Then how do I get past them? Okay, hold on. I have an idea. Alright, so his knee. I have a tiny hammer, and there's his knee. What's this going to do?
Dr. Roberts here. Well, let's test your reflexes.
Well, that was quite the coincidence. I did all of that just to get an exclamation mark. Why?
The wooden exclamation mark that fell off the sign. I could put it after all of my sentences, but then I wouldn't know what's really important anymore.
Yeah, how does that help me do anything? I could paint it black? Why? Exclamation mark covered in black varnish.
Now I have an exclamation mark that's covered in black varnish.
It actually looks like a delicious cookie thing, but again, why? Oh. It looks like a boot print. I'm not sure how that's gonna get me through here, but it's gotta be it, right?
I don't know what I'm supposed to do. Well, I could.
But how do I...
Phew, they almost... An exclamation mark covered in black varnish.
Mm-hmm.
Why should I do...
I don't know. Why do you even have this?
That could be fun. No, I won't. He's not very clever, but he's also not blind.
Can I take it off now?
No, it's better.
Is it really? I really feel like I froze them in the wrong position, but maybe you don't have any choice over which position they're frozen in. Alright, so they're gonna follow this. Right. So I need to get them to go somewhere else?
No, I won't. He's not very...
Yeah.
I could hold it, but walk...
No. What if I have them walk back here? But then where are they gonna go? Other than find me?
I don't know... That won't work.
Like, where can I use this?
No.
Okay. Hint. Directs the marching guards by whistling. Maybe you could do that too. Oh, my nose! I forgot I can still use my nose flute. That doesn't sound anything like a parakeet at all, but... Okay. Okay.
Phew, they almost... I made wonderful tracks there.
I'm about to kill all of the guards. Well, okay. Here we go.
What have I done?
You're a murderer, Robert. You're a murderer.
Looks great. I think I've got talent.
Stop! Is that you on the poster? Then I would have to arrest you.
No. If I'm standing here, I can't be the guy on the poster, right?
My brain hurts.
Oh my god. Robert actually outwitted someone. I didn't know he was capable of outwitting anyone. Hey, look at the little fly. Even the flies are adorable.
Ha! Huh. My own wanted poster. I look dangerous.
Hey, it's forbidden to take the posters down.
I just looked. I didn't touch anything.
You look a little like the guy on the poster.
That's, my evil twin brother.
I see.
I mean, yes, exactly. High-tech something lab? Yeah, high-tech laboratory something something. Alright, that's obviously where I need to go. Looks like I can't go anywhere but up the stairs, though.
A god like any other. Pretty big, pretty blue, and unbelievably stupid. Hello.
I can't talk. I have to concentrate.
Of course.
If this is how you are, when you're concentrating, I would like to see you when you're not. Okay, let's go up.
Hey, what do you think you're doing?
I'm from the Stair Checking Commission. I just wanted to check these stairs for steps.
But someone was here for that just yesterday. Don't go up.
Ah.
I could hold it in front of my face. Look at me, but what kind of idiot would believe that?
That kind of idiot? That idiot would believe it. Okay. Well, my Conroy puppet can't really make a noise anymore. I don't think this is gonna work.
That could be fun.
No.
What? Nothing to say. It says, hey, look over there. Why did Laura give me this note?
I thought I would have to use this at some point, even though it's a joke. And I think I do, right here. Right? Hey, look over there, guard.
I have a message for you.
Oh, I love this game.
Look back there.
Look over there. What's over there? I can't see anything. Over there? Maybe I can see it if I look a little longer. Hey, what do you think you're doing?
Nothing.
I'm from the statue.
No, all right. Just go behind him.
Hey, boy, what do you think you're doing here?
I just wanted to go through that door.
No, I have orders not to let anyone in.
Can I just walk past him? This isn't working out as well as I thought it would. Okay, I have him looking the other way, but now what? Oh, do I just take down the poster?
Hey, it's forbidden to
Wait,
take
what?
The poster.
I just looked.
Seriously, he's looking the other way. How does he see me? What? I'm confused. What did that note even do? It doesn't seem to have affected anything. Where do I go from here? There's nothing back here. Can I take it? The flag?
No, it's better for...
Wait a minute.
I'm not the guy on the poster.
No. I was just wondering if I turned off the stove at home.
Did you?
I just remembered that I don't have a home.
Okay. I can give him the note again, but what is that going to do?
I have a...
Look over there. Oh. Hey, boy. No.
I don't get it. Get rid of the guard in front of the lab. Wait a minute. Do I? No, I don't get it. The guard seems to base his decisions of who he should arrest on the poster. Oh. Got it. Whoops, that's not what I meant to do.
That's just... I have a man.
Look. Oh. Wow. I never would have thought that of myself. Well then, I'd better arrest myself. Yes, that's what I should do. Will you cover me in the meantime?
Sure, I'd be glad to help.
Oh my god. I gotta say though, disappointingly, that's another poorly designed puzzle. I had him look the other way, and when I went to take down my poster, the guard saw me. Implying that I can't possibly do anything to the poster even when the guard is distracted, because he would see me. But then it turns out the solution is actually to change the poster. However, the guard just magically doesn't see you when you decide to use the replacement poster on it instead of trying to take down your own. So the game is communicating different things to me. It communicated originally that I can't mess with the poster even when he's distracted, and then later it communicated to me that, oh, actually you can. Like, if I could have just taken down my poster, then that would have absolutely communicated to me what to do. It would have been pretty obvious. We have an empty hole, I now have a poster, and I have another poster I could put up. It would have made sense. It would have made sense, but no, that is seriously bad design. Again, not a huge deal, but that definitely could have been designed a lot better. And it would have been very simple to do it. Just allow you to take down the poster. The original one, rather than having to use the new poster on the old one to do it. Alright, I'm guessing the door is locked. No, it's not. Okay. Well, now I'm curious. What's upstairs? What the heck?
I found him!
Is that your father?
Yes, I think he can hear me. Don't you think so?
The glass looks pretty thick. And he doesn't seem to notice that much anymore. Don't worry.
He knows I'm here. Dad!
Okay, come with me. We'll find a way to get him out of there.
No, I'm staying here. I don't want to leave him alone.
But you haven't seen him in years. A few more moments won't hurt. And you won't even notice, so...
Flute Nose, stop trying to comfort me.
Sorry, I better go.
Have fun. And don't die.
Okay.
Or I'll kill you.
Understood. All right, so I'm gonna...
Bye.
Bye. Okay, so I was wondering why he would, why her father would do something so evil as to make these bazillions. And I think we now have the answer. The answer is he wouldn't. Not on his own. They're basically leeching off of his intellect to create these things. Alright, there's a lot of stuff here. Assembly line blueprints, lifts and holes and grates.
An artificial hand making a fist.
That could come in handy. Replacement fist.
No, I shouldn't touch it. I don't feel like having my hand unscrewed. So that's Laura's father. His name is Dr. Remy Nepo. Hello, can you hear me?
Dad, can you hear me? We have to stop these electric shocks.
Yes, before his brain's completely toasted.
Yes. Okay, so apparently every time he does... What is it? Every time he stops working? He gets shocked? Shocked so that he goes back to work?
I believe these cables lead out from his head, or into his head. He's connected to the whole hangar. Creepy.
Very creepy, and also possibly advantageous. If he's connected to the whole hangar, maybe he could be used to control it.
No, I better leave them where they are. I'll just end up breaking something. The mechanical arms seem to be connected to his head. He controls the hands with his thoughts. Amazing.
Perhaps I could replace the hands with a fist to stop them from constructing stuff and make them punch stuff instead or something.
No, I don't want to be transformed into a bazillion.
But I'd probably have to stop the production line to do that.
No, I don't want...
Yeah, okay.
Blueprints for a bazillion. Conroy, that madman. All this time he's been terrorizing the people with machines. No, I don't want... There are...
Oh, did I just... Oh. Oh, he's right down there. Hmm. What? What are these things? Are those tiny... bunnies? They seem to be alive because their eyes are blinking. What the heck? That's interesting.
That weird guy is hunting it. I bet that if he gets it, he'll be sad. I can't reach it. I guess he can use this button to call the lift.
Oh, and it can go up and down by all of 2 feet.
Ha! That's where the lift goes.
Wait a minute. How does he get in and out of here? Where's the door? Does it come up and out through the grating? Shouldn't there be like a ladder? Does it go through the lift? It doesn't look big enough. At least not big enough to comfortably fit through. I guess maybe you could squeeze in there.
A red glowing button. That can't be good. The bazillion parts that Reminepo built are being transported there. It's quite calming after you've stared at it for a while.
I really want to know what these bunny things are. Alright, do I have anything I could possibly use? Fist? Note?
What? Nothing to say.
Yes, I will use this to win.
I can't do that. There used to be a button there. Now there's only a hole which cannot be pressed.
Ah, crap. Nothing I have would work.
Why should I do that? A lift. I think it's meant for food, but I'm not sure. It's empty, but I don't think I will fit in there.
No. What if I put Laura's note in there? Did that not work? Wow, okay, the game doesn't even dignify me with a response. Fine, I guess it was that bad of an idea. All right, so go check up the stairs.
Fonk? I'm in the throne hall again? Oh, please, no. This brings back memories. Over there is my bunk, and back there is my dream corner. I always sat there and dreamt about being someone who didn't need a dream corner. But this here is new. Hmm, looks like Asposia, only darker and without life. I have a bad feeling. Oh no, I don't want to stay here again. Okay, calm down. How can I get out of here? There was a clicking sound behind the painting.
Okay. So we're finally back here. Look at that. It's terrorizing Asposia. The bazillions. It's like all-out war going on. Well, can it even be called war? I mean, I don't think anybody can fight back against the bazillions, can they? It would just be a slaughter.
Conroy's medicine cabinet. Only 2 bottles are still full. Conroy's anti-dandruff fish oil and his knockout drops. There are more and more of them. I need to hurry.
Look at all the phosphoruses.
fancy and posh, with a big diamond on it.
They're always so happy, look at them. Alright, so there's something about this painting. What did he say, that this reminded him of the, happiest day of his life? So what is that image showing? Is that showing him protecting the people against the bazillions? As if he's some great defender of the people, even though he's the one that made them?
When the throne was closing, something made a clicking sound around here. It must have something to do with that painting.
Oh, whoops, didn't mean to skip that.
I don't know where to start searching. The clicking noise sounded like it came from the painting. But it's huge.
Yes, it is.
I can't do that. Conroy's anti-dandruff fish oil. The smell reminds me of him. That's one of Conroy's home remedies. He would take it at night when he couldn't sleep or was lonely. Conroy's throne. Definitely way too big for him. You can certainly tell it belongs to Conroy.
Well, now I have a spring. I didn't expect that. Hey, Funk. Oh, you're, Quill, so you're, damn, what was it? Fuck, I'm forgetting the name of it. What's the thing that has quills? Come on, I can remember. Come on, brain. Remember the name of the creature that has quills. It's not a badger, right? I don't think it's a badger. No, it's not a badger. Come on. This is gonna drive me crazy. Hedgehog, right? Okay, whew. I feel better. It's a hedgehog.
That hedgehog has always hated me. His favorite pastime was to roll up wherever I was about to sit down. I think Conroy taught him that.
Wouldn't surprise me. Well, how about you have some knockout drops?
I can't do that.
Alright, might need to put it in the form of food or something. That could come in handy.
One of Funk's quills. Long, skinny, and sharp. The model of a bushy-tailed bazillion.
Model bazillion?
A model of Asposia, but it looks different. Dark. Sad. Orderly.
Oh. Just like Conroy, right? Alright, so he was trying to, or he is, trying to take over Asposia and bend it to his will.
I can't take that with me. It's far too depressing anyway.
Fair enough. Alright, a model bazillion. Don't know what the heck I'm gonna do with that. God, look at that. Why is there a shackle there? Was that where I was kept? And why are there spikes in the ground as if they're meant to stop cars from driving over it in one direction? What is that about? Do those go up and, like, seal you in there?
A bazillion attack! I have to stop Conroy before he lets even more bazillions loose on the people. It's too dangerous out there, and too high to jump down. A piece of artwork. I don't get it, so it must be art. Oh, I destroyed art. Hey, Conroy's powdered sugar is in there.
Powdered are you sure that's powdered sugar?
Conroy's secret supply of powdered sugar. He used to tell me how it kept him alert and awake when he needed to govern throughout the night.
That's adorable. Okay, it's obviously... Wow. So this game's obviously meant to be, child-friendly. So I suspect... Yeah, I mean, that's obviously cocaine, right? But they're calling it powdered sugar. That's kind of brilliant, right? Because a kid would never know what that is, right? They wouldn't even think anything of it. It's powdered sugar. But anyone older would realize that a white powder used by a person who has a lot of drugs in their cabinet to keep them alert and awake at night is cocaine.
No, I won't just take it with bare hands. Sometimes Conroy would give it to me when I was little. He thought it was funny how hyper it made me. It took me forever to kick the habit.
But, and it's also clever because, you know, hyper is commonly thought to... Did I just say hyper? Sugar is commonly thought to make you hyper. So it's kind of doubly clever. It kind of works even if you don't think it's cocaine. That is really clever. Alright, could I put it in anything? Rublazman fist.
No, I don't want to sprinkle powder on that.
No, what can I sprinkle powder on? There we go.
A white bazillion. Funny. His eyes look a lot bigger all of a sudden.
Okay. Now what am I going to do with that? There's actually nothing I can interact with down there. So it's got to be something over here. Can I just give it to... Wait a minute, hold on. Knockout drops?
That could be fun.
No. No...
He won't touch the bazillion. He doesn't seem to like it.
Alright, I need to make him like it. What would make him like it?
That's just a random...
Yes, it is. Put his quills in it? What would that do?
That's just...
No.
Conroy's anti-dandruff fish oil. The smell reminds me of him.
Alright, the smell reminds me of him. That makes me think I need to put that on it so that it'll smell like Conroy.
I can't do that.
But it doesn't work.
That's just...
What if I combine it with a Conroy puppet?
Why should I do that?
I don't know.
That's just...
Alright. What the heck?
Ha! Huh. Fingerprints around a suspicious-looking notch.
I just used cocaine to dust for fingerprints. I never thought I'd do that. Okay, wow. Okay, so it's not used for, fonk. No, it's gone.
It's way too narrow. My finger won't fit in there.
Oh, but a quill will.
Better leave the quill in there, so the throne won't close.
Okay, now I can travel freely. But what am I gonna do with this stuff? Guess I'll just leave for now and see if I can think of anything to do with my current items.